Welcome to the MVC Memorial Hall. My name is Walt Tanimoto. I am an Army Iraq War veteran and the current commander of the MVC. I'd like to tell you how the NISAE Veterans Committee got started, or as we call ourselves, the MVC. Despite the NISAE's meritorious wartime achievements, the returning World War II NISAE soldiers faced racial discrimination and prejudice. They were rejected by some veteran organizations in the Pacific Northwest, such as the American Legion and the Veterans of Foreign Wars. For example, in the spring of 1945, Richard Naito, a disabled veteran, was recuperating from wartime injuries at a hospital in Spokane, Washington, but was denied membership in the local VFW because of his Japanese ancestry. Also in 1945, an American Legion post in Hood River, Oregon, removed the names of 16 NISAE soldiers from their honor roll. One of the names removed was that of Frank Hachia, who was killed in action in the Philippines and was awarded the Silver Star for his bravery. Due to racial discrimination and prejudice, a group of recently discharged NISAE veterans in Seattle who served in the 442nd Regimental Combat Team and the Military Intelligence Service established the Seattle NISAE Veterans Committee on 25 March 1946. Harry Takagi was one of the leaders in establishing the Seattle NVC, and in recognition of his leadership, he was elected the first commander. Early NVC leaders included Albert Lefty Ichihara, Shiro Kashino, Dick Setsuda, Bill Nishimura, Joe Nakatsu, and Joe Hamanaka, and many others who gave the MVC a strong foundation that enabled the organization to thrive. One of the purposes of the MVC was to sustain the strong personal relationships that were formed during the war. These relationships served as a bond for members of the MVC and their families throughout their lives, even today. The MVC's constitution and bylaws were adopted on 2 June 1946, and the MVC was established as a veterans organization. Many of the founding members were fiercely independent, and the constitution and bylaws required the organizations to be self-supporting, non-political, and independent of outside influence. Membership was open to any honorably discharged veteran who supported the patriotic goals and the aspirations of the MVC. The early membership of the MVC was made up of primarily those who had served in the 442nd because they had returned home earlier than many who served in the MIS and other armed forces organizations. Today, the MVC is made up of veterans who served from World War II through today's fight against the global war on terrorism. We work together to continue the legacy of the NISAE veterans through community and civic activities, social activities, education, and scholarship programs. Additionally, some of our members are still serving in the armed forces, continuing their legacy of the NISAEs. From those who followed on your footsteps and this sansei, we are here to honor you who fought for our freedom. Though it was many years ago, we still stand on your shoulders today. Thank you, NISAEs.